I cried a few times when I first moved to United States. Sorry. Hey guys, so today's video is gonna be a little bit calm since I got a request from one of my followers on Facebook said that I should make a video about how is it like I moved from Cambodia to the United States or to the other countries. I know there's a lot of people, especially me from Cambodia, I always think that moving to a Western country is really a great deal. Can make so much money here and we live really great life and everything is just wonderful. But that's not about it. My first experience living in the other country is I moved from Cambodia to Sweden. I live in Sweden with my husband for like 3 years there. The life is the big changing, especially the weather, the food, the people, and missing home, missing friends. It just, the culture is just so much different. The weather is super cold in Sweden, like cold, cold, cold that I never experienced before in my life. It was a big changing. The end of 2015, we moved to United States. I didn't expect that it such a big changing from Cambodia to Sweden, from Sweden to United States. In Sweden, they have buses, they have trains, they have really good transportations there that you can just go places. It's super nice. But when you come to United States, and of course when you live in like downtown New York, or you live in downtown Chicago, or downtown Washington DC, of course they have trains, they have buses and stuff because it's a big tourist place. If for example like me, I live in North Carolina, so like there's no trains or anything. So it's such a big changing. If you don't drive, you're gonna stuck at home a lot. The big changing one is the language. You don't speak the language. You have to go to school. But if you learn some from Cambodia, for example, if you know you move to the United States, you can learn a little bit English so you can be prepared and come here. They also have free school for you that you can go and take courses and stuff. But that is gonna be hard because you need someone to drive you there. But if you live close to bus stop and stuff like that, it's easy. But if you don't, it's gonna be hard for you. And second is driving. For example, like me, I never knew how to drive. In Cambodia, I only rode a moto. In Sweden, I took buses and trains. So when I came to United States, learning how to drive, it was a big disaster. I was 3 months pregnant when I learned how to drive in the US, and I actually got into accidents and our front car, it just smooshed into some private company, whatever it is. And then after that, I didn't learn how to drive for almost 2 years because every time I got behind the wheels, it reminded me of that, you know, accident. And the other one is food. You're gonna miss your own traditional food just so much that you just wanna cry whenever you think about I wanna eat that, but I can't. I cried a few times when I first moved to United States. Sorry. Because I was pregnant and then all I was craving for is Cambodian food. I'm sorry, but I know it's not a big deal, I can get over it, but you know, when you got pregnant, you're so emotional, your hormones all over the place. So I actually cried a few times. I talked to my husband, can you just send me to Cambodia for like 3 months? And then after I finish like, you know, the craving thing, I can just come back after 3 months. But you know, when you don't really work, only your husband works, the income is really tight, and the plane ticket from the United States to Cambodia is expensive. I mean, if you live in California and stuff, I think the plane ticket should be better because it's close to Cambodia. Where we live in North Carolina, it's not. And it's gonna be really hard for you to find, especially Asian stores. And even you have Asian stores, some Asian stores, they don't carry whatever food that you usually got in Cambodia. I mean, like my sister, she lives in Long Beach. It's really great because they got a lot of Cambodian foods there. But me, I live in North Carolina. It took us about 20 minutes to drive to Asian store, which is great. It's not that far. So for example, if I want to make rice porridge, I spend so much money to get all the spices, all the ingredients before I can get a bowl of rice porridge. Okay. And then the other one is friends. You know, like in Cambodia, you can see friends so often. Like, you know, you grow up there, you went to school and everything. So it's kind of like, you know, tight community. But when you come here, everything is new. You need to make a new friend, which is not really easy to make a new friend, especially in the United States. But if you live, for example, my sister lives in Long Beach, really good for her because a lot of Cambodians live there. So it's easy for her to speak in Cambodia and they have some Cambodian community and stuff like that. When I moved to North Carolina, I hardly met any Cambodians people. There is a pagoda that I went to like for New Year's, for Phnom Penh and stuff like that. And it takes us about an hour and a half to drive there. And I met some Cambodian there, but we live so far apart, like just so far away from each other, so we hardly see each other, then we don't get close at all. And another one is family. Family is really important for especially our Cambodian family. You know, like we always so close together, especially like us when we move to the other country. We got pregnant, we have kids. Sometimes we just don't have help at all. In Cambodia, when you get pregnant, you gave birth and stuff like that, a whole family just came together, help you. It's just so much going on, so much support that it's really great, especially for a mother. It's really good for her mental health and stuff like that. But in the United States, when I had Julia in 2016, in the whole world, it's just by myself, my daughter, and my husband. You got really, really lonely because my husband got only 2 weeks off. So after that, my husband went to work. It's just me and my daughter, my tiny baby daughter at home for 24 hours. So then you got kind of depressed. That is the thing. You got lonely and then of course you got depressed because it's just you and your daughter at home the whole time. I mean, if you drive, it's great. You can just go to the park and stuff. But if you don't drive, you're gonna stuck at home and wait for your husband to get off work so you can go places that you wanna go. And then the other one is about money. Most people think moving to the USA is really great. It's a lot of money, which it's not true at all. Everything is expensive. If like me, I go to work a place or something, I got paid minimum wage, like $8 or $10 per hour, which is great. It sounds a lot, right? But the thing is, food expensive, clothes expensive, everything is expensive. You had to pay for car insurance, you had to pay for this and that. And if you don't get a house yet, which means you live in an apartment, it's still expensive. If both of you works, like you and your husband works, it's great. It like two incomes. But if you stuck at home, your husband's only one's going to work, it's only one income. It sounds like he makes so much money, but at the end of the month, when you paid everything, the rent, the car, the incident, the food, the blah blah blah, you almost didn't have any money left. And so don't think that people live in the United States or the other Western country is rich. So living in the US or the other countries, it's not as amazing as you guys think. Most people like, oh, I want to move to the other countries, I want to have Western husband, I want to move to the US, I want to do this and do that. But before you guys decide to do that, you guys need to figure out what is the difference when you come here. Far away from family, money is not easy to make, everything is expensive. If you know how to try, it's great, but if you don't, it's gonna be a little bit not so good. I hope this video will help you guys a little bit, you know, to understand what to expect when you move to the other countries. It's not as amazing as you guys think, okay? I love you all.